The link again where you can go to get the data sets. Now we're going to jump into doing these live demos, and you can download them here from this page, autode.sk/GDR. The first workflow that I'm going to show you is a bubble diagramming workflow. So looking at space planning and looking at a program that we have in Excel, a list of spaces in a clinic. And we're going to evaluate designs based on the adjacencies that we want. Again, this is the web page you'll get to, and you can download this bubble diagram workflow here. Now, when you download that, it's probably going to be blocked from functioning correctly, because when you get things from the internet, Windows does a great job of protecting the files that you download from the internet. And if you want to just unblock them, you can go to the properties and just hit this unblock option here. And that will let you use these files, right? But I've unzipped them already into this folder here called Bubble Diagrammer. And you can see we have a Dynamo script here, we have an image, we have a Revit file, and we have our program here. And those are all the components that we need to run this study. So let's go to Revit, and we're gonna open this clinic layout.rvt. And this is just a simple Revit file. It just has a space that will fit our program. And one note on the space requirements to use this script is that it has to be a convex shape. It can't have a island in it, or it can't be like an L form. It needs to be kind of a shape like this. Okay, so we're going to go to the generative design tools on the manage tab here. We have our generative design tools, and these are the tools that are part of the AEC collections exclusively. And they allow you to access design studies directly without having to go through Dynamo. Now, you can actually access these tools also through Dynamo. If you want to control how they're working, you want to tweak them, you can certainly do that too. But I'm going to show you today just the tools, how you can use the tools that are on the Manage tab that you don't have to go through Dynamo. Because a lot of our users told us that they don't want to deal with Dynamo. They just want to try to use these tools in the Revit context. Okay, so when we open up our Create Study dialog, we have a list of Autodesk samples. And these are some of the samples that you saw in the videos that I showed you earlier. And these are just samples that we have developed that are ways that people can investigate some of these workflows. But we can also add new folders. So I'm going to go and I'm going to add the bubble diagrammer folder that I put into sample files when I unzipped it in its unblocked state. And I'm going to select that and add that to my manage folders lists. And then it will show up here so that I can run this study. You'll notice here that there's also tools to, if I wanted to edit this in Dynamo, I could go and edit it from in Dynamo, or I could get to its folder, but I'm just going to go ahead and run it. And you'll see a couple things here that are required inputs for this study. So we need a room, and then we need a program file where our program for our clinic lives. We're going to look at that in more detail in a minute, but let's select this room. So we come in here to Revit and select a room, and then we have our Revit data going into this study. And then we're also going to come and select this sample building program clinic Excel file, and we'll have that as part of our study. And then we're just going to go ahead and run it, and we'll see kind of what happens with this study. And while that is kicking off, I'm just going to open up this program for a minute and show you what our program is that it's helping us lay out. So all the gray columns in here are things that are not being taken into account right now, but the white columns are things that are in play. So we have here, we have a list of spaces, a waiting area, a telephone area, vending machine, toilet, et cetera. We have a list of departments. We have a list of areas for each space. And then we have a list of adjacencies. And these are kind of in European notation saying what they want to be next to, and that's listed by their ID here. So you can see that the entrance wants to be by 4, 7, and 8. So it wants to be by the vending machine, the lockers, and the care team. So that makes sense, right? Okay, so while we were looking at that, we have generated some options here, and we can start to look at those, all the different ways that it's laying out those spaces based on this list and the adjacencies that we wanted. And we can actually start to evaluate them based on a certain metric that we're calculating. And that metric is how well do each of these layouts do for the adjacencies that we wanted. So I'm going to toggle this to be the highest adjacency score. So you can see here that the adjacency score is 339. And then the lowest adjacency score here is 159. So I'm going to go with the best adjacency score. And I can then come and put these into my Revit file here. And I'm actually going to put them into different design options because I want to use this as a starting point for my design. And I want to keep track of some of these different design options in Revit and use it as a base for my exploration. So I'm just going to I have some options set up here. And if I set up the options, I can take the one with the best score here, and I can create my Revit elements directly into my Revit file. And this will just make it a part of my Revit file. Takes just a minute, and there's a Dynamo script again running in the background, which is going to create these for me. And it's created a family that has things like the space name and the department name. So that's pretty cool. So let's do another one. We'll go to option 2, and I'm going to create this option 2 in Revit as well. I just wanted to show you that you can make a sheet and you can see them all next to each other. I could go and put the rest of them in, use this as a base to work from.